Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let me show you how to create a pop-out magnifying glass effect in Keynote. MacMost is brought to you thanks to its community of supporters. Join us plus get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So let's say you're giving a presentation and you're showing an image and there's a certain part of that image that you want to focus on. There's no built-in effect for that, but it's pretty easy to build kind of a magnifying glass that pops out of the image to a larger portion of it. So here I have a blank Keynote presentation and I'm going to start by dragging an image into it. I'm going to center that image here. And what I want to do is I'm going to focus on one of these windows. So I'm going to add a shape, and what makes most sense is to add a circle shape, but I could use any shape. I'm going to put that here over the window. I'm going to hold the shift key down as I do it so it keeps a circular shape and doesn't become oval. I'm going to get it perfectly positioned over the window. Now I'm going to drag and drop that same exact image again, but this time into the shape. When I do, I'm instantly in the mode where I'm moving the image around to fit into the shape. The masking mode. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually lock this image on top of the other image. Notice how it snaps into place. So it's really easy to get it perfect. And then I'll hit done. Now I actually have a circle with the image in it that's at the same scale. So it appears invisible because it's actually locked to the same area. At this point I could actually just grab a corner there and enlarge the entire thing, move that to another section, and I could be done. But I want to animate it. I'll undo to get it back where it was. I'll go on the right here, click on Animate and Action and add an effect. And the effect we want to add is Scale. And you can see it puts a little default scale in there where it gets a little bit bigger. To make it even bigger still, I'm going to grab a corner here and drag that to make it nice and large. Now I could preview this and see what happens. But the next thing I want to do is I want to move it out of the way. So I'm going to click Add Action here. And I'm going to select Move. It's going to give me the default move just a little bit to the right like that. I'm actually going to drag it to the upper right hand corner, use the arrow keys to move it a little bit away from the edges there, and now I've got it moving from its original position to the upper right hand corner. But the problem is it's going to do one after the other. So it's going to enlarge and then it's going to move. If I click Build Order I could see this. First it's going to scale, then it's going to move. So I want to select Move here and say start that with Build 1. And you can see it joins them together. It's going to do both at the same time now. So now when I preview this it's going to both move and scale. And I get my effect. Next let's add a border and a shadow. So to do that first I'm going to click outside of that so the preview goes away. I'm going to select the circle that I know that's there. And I'm going to go to Format and I'm going to create a border. I'll just use the default there but you can set a color and all of that. And for shadow I'm going to create a drop shadow. So now I'll go to Animate again, Show Actions, and Preview. And you can see it does that. One problem though is that at the beginning of the animation here I've got the circle and drop shadow so it kind of looks odd. So I'm going to add a third type of animation. I'm going to select it, Show Actions, and I see those, add another action, and this time I'm going to add Opacity. And I'm going to say I want it to transition to 100%. So end at 100%. How do I change the beginning of that? Well, I'm going to click away from it again and click it. So I select it without all the animation stuff. And I'm going to go to Format and then Opacity here. I'm going to change that to 0. Make it disappear along with the border and the shadow. So now we want to make sure that all three animations happen at the same time. So I'll go to Animate and go to Build Order and I'll see that opacity is now happening after those other ones. I want to have that start with build one as well so all three happen together. Now when I preview you could see it does that. So it starts off with nothing there and then it becomes visible, it enlarges, and it moves all at once.
So this is a great effect to use in presentations. You can even do more than one on a single slide. You can also of course export any Keynote presentation as video so you can use this in your iMovie projects.